Hi, this is Rajesh Kumar. I am going to present a project, Aadhaar enabled secure driver identity. In this project, I am going to cover the topics are, what is Aadhaar, and UIDAI. In Aadhaar, I am going to cover what is Aadhaar application. And two steps in Aadhaar. And then Aadhaar usage. Then flow diagram of Aadhaar. How the Aadhaar application works. And then component structure of Aadhaar. In that component structure, I am going to explain about CAGR, ASA, AAA, and how the technology is used in this. And the next one is what is ASA. Next, how the Aadhaar application is implemented in financial transaction. These are all the topics I am going to cover in this project. First, let me see what is Aadhaar. Aadhaar is a 12-digit unique identification number. Most of the public and private service agencies requires proof of identity to provide the service. This Aadhaar is used to identify and authenticate the residents who are residing in this India. What is Aadhaar enabled services? An application which uses Aadhaar to identify and authenticate each and every individual in India to provide the service is called Aadhaar enabled services. What is UIDAI? UIDAI is nothing but it stands for Unique Identification Authority of India, which is an agency of government of India which takes responsibilities to implement the Aadhaar applications. The services in the sense bank account, resuming pension and during travel, and also the proofs such as passport, driving license, and then ration card, voter ID card. These are all the identification mainly used by the residents in India. This UIDAI uses the identification information are demographic and also the biometric. The demographic involves name, address, contact number, and email ID, all those things. And also the biometric information are, biometric is nothing but using the biological information we are going to identify and authenticate the human who resides. And the biometric information are iris, because each and every human individuals, the iris pattern will be unique, and also the fingerprint and face recognition, and also the voice recognition. These are all the demographic and biometric informations. And what are the two steps in Aadhaar applications? The main two steps are identity creation and identity authentication. First, identity creation. What is the identity creation in Aadhaar applications? In Aadhaar application, we are going to identify an individual who is resides in India. This is to identify and authenticate the individual person. There are types of identity are, there are three types in identity, that is what the user known. Second one is what the user has. And next one is user's biometric information. What the user known, login username, password, security questions, and his personal informations. These are all the things user known. And what the user has? User has the proof identity such as passport, ration card, driving license, voter ID. All those things are user has as a identification proof. And next one is user's biometric information. User biometric information such as iris pattern, fingerprint, and face recognition, and also the voice recognition. These are all the identity types in this identity creation. Next one is identity authentication. What is identity authentication means, if Aadhaar holder is giving a request to the authentication device, the authentication device will check the database and it will respond to the Aadhaar holder is nothing but identity authentication in Aadhaar applications. There are three types in identity authentication, that is, one is manual, electronic, and both manual and electronic. What is manual? Manual authentication. Manual authentication is nothing but the demographic information are verified with the records already stored in the governmental proofs. So it is manually done by the officer. And next one is electronic authentication. Electronic authentication is nothing but user can, while he creates his identity, user can give his iris pattern and fingerprint and face recognition and also the voice recognition. By the use of that, the machine can authenticate the user whether who is responsible for the service or not. Then both. In this, the both manual and electronic authentication is done here. And Aadhaar usages. The main Aadhaar usages are establishing a presence and proof of delivery. Next one is establishing known your customer credentials. There are three types in establishing presence and proof of delivery. That are all confirming beneficiary, and attendance, last one is financial transaction. First, confirming the beneficiary. Confirming the beneficiary is nothing but if the user have gotten any services from the service provider, the entry is given to the user, and after that he cannot able to request for the same service. So that the confirming the beneficiary is needed in this other application. Next one is attendance tracking. In attendance tracking, the SSA council, that is students and teachers in the schools or colleges, students and teachers are giving their attendance by the use of attendance tracking. In that also we are using the Aadhaar application. And the next one is financial transaction. Financial transaction is nothing but bank transaction and credit card transaction. We are using this Aadhaar card because it is in Aadhaar card the number is unique because it is not transferable. So the account is not hacked and the financial transaction in this the credit card and the bank amounts are safe. Next one is establishing known your customer credentials. In this there are three types that are all KYC, various services, and general poll. Demographic verification. First, KYC, various. There are many service providers provide their services to the customers. There are various services like in ration and passport and voter ID card. There are many service providers in this India. They are using this Aadhaar application. By the use of Aadhaar application, they won't get additionally they won't get services. Next, general poll. In general poll is nothing but in airport and all, if any customer is enter inside, the entry is must, because the in airport and all there are very secured places, so the entry is must. By the in that also they are using the Aadhaar application for the general poll and demographic verification. Demographic verification is nothing but if any service provider is there, if any customer goes for an any services, they verify their demographic informations. And authentication overview. What the Aadhaar card will do and what it will not do. In Aadhaar card, we are storing all the information in CIDR, not in the card. Because of that, if anybody want to know about that Aadhaar holder, they cannot able to identify that because the informations are in CIDR. So that means Central Identity Data Repository. In Aadhaar card, in smart card, in previous days they are storing the informations and the name and account numbers in the cards so that they can easily hack. And if any Aadhaar holder or authentication device is giving a request to that CIDR will not provide the personal informations or Aadhaar identification number or any things to that service holder. It will respond only yes and yes or no. And this is the process diagram of Aadhaar application. First, Aadhaar holder send authentication request to the Aadhaar authentication device. Then that Aadhaar authentication device forward the request to that AUA. AUA is nothing but authentication user agency. This authentication user agency having the middleware of ASA, that is authentication server agency, which is communicate with that AUA or ASA specific protocol, then it will send a request to that CIDR. In that CIDR, they are verifying and authenticate the request. After that, by the use of HTTP protocol, they are giving the request response as yes or no to that ASA. The ASA will forward the request to that AUA. And according to the service, the authentication device update and configure the request, and then it give it to the authentication device. Then authentication device provide the service if the response is yes, and otherwise it will neglect if the response is no. This is the process done in Aadhaar applications, and this one is the component diagram of Aadhaar applications. In this component diagram, we are seeing the UIDI and CIDR. Next one is ASA and AUA. First, UIDI. UIDI is nothing but Unique Identification Authority of India, who will provide the Unique Identification Number to the Aadhaar holder. Aadhaar holder, if Aadhaar holder want to any services, he will request to the CIDR by the use of ASA and AUA. In this CIDR is nothing but a Central Identity of Data Repository, Central Identity of Data Repository. It is nothing but a database which is storing the data of Aadhaar holder. And this is the ASA. ASA is nothing but Authentication Service Agency, and AVA is nothing but Authentication User Agency. In this, the Aadhaar holder send a request to the CIDR, that is Central Identification Data Repository. This will forward the request to the ASA. ASA means Authentication Service Agency. It will look forward to the AUA. In this AUA, we are using the authentication devices such as iris scanner, fingerprint scanner, and face recognizer, and also the voice recognizer. We are already storing the information about the Aadhaar holder, and it will match with that CIDR information and the incoming request. And after that, it will provide the service to that user. This is the component diagram. And the next one, what is CIDR? CIDR is nothing but Central Identity of Data Repository. It is the database which store the information about the Aadhaar holder, such as photo proof, name, address, and phone number, and also the personal identification informations which are storing in the CIDR. In that CIDR, we are storing much small informations about the user. By the use of that, we are authenticate the user. And the next one is ASA. ASA is nothing but Authentication Service Agency. In this we will see what is the authentication agency briefly. This is the block diagram for Authentication Service Agency. In this, this Authentication Service Agency is act as a middleware which is between the AEA and the CADR. If any request is coming from the AEA, which will forward, the ASA will forward the request to the CADR. In the CADR, we are performing the verification and authentication process. After that, we are giving the response to the AUA. In AUA process, we are having the HTTP handler and message handler and also verification and authentication service. First, what is HTTP handler? HTTP handler is used to request and manages the request and response. And if any request is coming from coming as HTTP, which will manage by the use of HTTP handler. If any request is coming from the message, coming as a message, we are using the message handler. We are managing that. And this authentication service agency supports multiple protocol. Multiple protocol, multiple data types, and data transaction, data type transaction, and also the validation service and authentication service, and also it will report to the CADR and the request to be sent to the AVA. These are all the things in that ASA service. After that, we will see what are the things, if the other application is used in financial transaction, what the process is done over here. If the other holder is send a request to the bank authority, he will ask for that unique identification number. After that, the request is sent to the CADI. It will communicate with the satellite so that the CADI will send the one-time password to the user as well as the authentication user agency. When the other holder send a request to the bank authority, this password is sent to the AUA by the use of web server. After that, the authentication process is done over AUA. In that, they will match the both passwords, and if it is correct, they will confirming the other holder to the transaction process. If it is no, he will reject the other holder. And we will see what is the process to create this CADR. And here CADR is nothing but database. In this there are main steps are loading the JDBC driver and connecting the DBMS and creating and executing a statement and process the data which is returned by the DBMS, and then we are closing the connections. First, loading the JDBC driver. By the use of Java, we are loading the JDBC driver by the use of class dot for name of sun dot JDBC ODBC dot JDBC ODBC driver. By the use of this command, we are creating the database. After that, we are connecting the database to the DBMS. In this, we are using the URL and username and password of the database, and we are getting the connection from that by the use of these commands. And we are creating and executing the SQL query. If we want to see what are the other holder information stored in the database, we are searching the other identification information by the use of select query. In this, we are passing the query as argument After that, we are processing the data and returned by the DBMS. In this process, the data is retrieved from the database. After that, we are terminating the database connection. The main use of the other applications are, it is highly secured because of the unique identification number, and each and every citizen resides in India uses the other applications, and it does not allow the duplication of applications of any type of card, any type of identification. It is exclusively used for passport theft. If any identification is theft, we can use it as a main identification.